The site is relatively quiet right now. I can hear a seagull in the background. Doesn't look like anything exciting happened here. But a little over a year ago, there was a big barge sitting out in this inner slip, and there were probably, you know, two or three dozen workers. Big crane was dredging material, swinging it over, placing it into the inner slip. I think that the LSP program is uniquely suited for a project like this.
The LSP program in Massachusetts is a mature program at this point. Properties are bought and sold that are contaminated and are stamped clean by an LSP.
Our goal was to create a reusable property, obviously. Cleaning up this slip was one of the first steps that we needed to complete in order to make this former industrial property available for redevelopment. Before our cleanup started, we had sheen on surface water in the inner slip. It extended into the outer slip, and we had to capture that with adsorbent booms and that sort of thing. We were keeping an eye. We'd collected samples and sediment and some of the biota at the bottom, clams and fish, to observe the conditions there. What we do now to monitor the effectiveness of our remedy is we'll actually go in and do some underwater videos. We've already done one. We have others planned in the future to confirm that the animals that live on the bottom are coming back and repopulating that. The solidified material is perfectly suitable for constructing a building on, having a parking lot. People can walk across it without fear of exposure to those contaminants. So yes, one of the primary purposes of that cleanup was to make this property available for redevelopment and productive reuse.
At GEI, we have constructed housing developments on contaminated properties. We've built parks on contaminated properties, built bridges, and worked on tunneling projects. About any type of project that you can imagine can now be constructed on contaminated properties.
The LSP program really encourages a high level of dialogue and participation by the most skilled people for these types of projects. In a sense, it takes some of the weight and responsibility off of the state by tasking that to this large group of experienced professionals, making them essentially representatives of the Commonwealth without having to put them on the full-time roles. And I think that's one of the big advantages of the LSP program to other programs in other states.
We have a big set of regulations that we need to comply with. That's part of our charge. But we can also use a lot of creativity and also be advocating for our clients while we're complying with the regulations.
I think this is a great example of how the LSP program can allow a really complicated site go from design to permitting to regulatory closure in a very short period of time.